Author Janet Uhlar coming to the Thomas Crane Public Library this month on Tuesday, September 11th from 7 to 8 p.m. to talk about her latest book, The Truth Be Damned. This is part of the library's Crime by the Book series, but she's here right now to give us a little bit of a preview about this project and about the presentation. So Janet, welcome. Thanks for coming.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
Great to have you. As I mentioned, this is your latest book, so you have two previous books.
Yes, I do. Two books on the American Revolution.
Yeah,
actually.
So this is quite a turn of events for you.
Definitely.
So tell us about yourself, first of all, if you could.
Well, I was born and raised in Quincy.
Oh.
So it's always considered my home. I live on the Cape right now.
Okay.
As you said, I wrote the other two books, and that's my passion, the American Revolution. But then I was put on the jury of the Whitey Bulger trial and felt like I needed to write about that, and so I did.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Now, talk a little bit about how the first two books came about, you know, American history. So were you trained in that field?
No, I'm actually a nurse by profession.
Oh, okay.
But developed a passion for the American Revolution while in third grade in Quincy,
yep,
elementary school, and it was the teacher that inspired me to fall in love with that period of history.
Okay, yeah. Well, of course, here you are in the heart of where,
yes,
it all started, so how could you not be influenced by that? Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
Wow. But you mentioned you were picked for the jury. You were juror number 12, I guess, right?
Juror number 12, yeah. The perfect juror, because I had been out of the state for the 30 years that most of the time Bulger was most active,
okay,
and avoided anything to do with organized crime. It just didn't interest me. I'm probably the only person my age that can say I never read The Godfather or saw the movie.
Wow. Okay. So this was your first introduction into this. Yeah. Wow. What was that like?
You know, going into the trial, I expected to be horrified by Bulger's criminality, the little that I knew about him.
Mm.
And my background in the American Revolution and my writing background, I made sure to put that down on the questionnaire in the initial jury pool. So one, they'd know that I did write books and I might just write a book,
mm-hmm,
and also that I had this background in the American Revolution and understood the principles of the founding fathers.
Mm-hmm.
They chose me anyway.
Much to your chagrin or not.
And then in opening statements, when Bulger's own attorney stated that his client was guilty of most of the charges, my response was, "What are we doing here?" And I kind of realized it was going to be more than met the eye.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I mean, did you have to, when in putting this project together, because that was only, 5 years ago?
Yes.
Did you have to kind of reschool yourself in writing a crime novel?
A little bit, because it was very different from what I had done. I wrote it as a Romana Clay, if you will, per legal counsel, just because that way I could say more without, you know, identifying individuals necessarily.
Okay, all right.
Because my focus in the book wasn't so much Bulger's criminality, but it was the horrifying depth of corruption within the Boston Department of Justice.
Wow,
yeah.
Really? Okay.
And so following the trial, I tried to research out what I knew they didn't tell us during the trial. A jury's supposed to, you know, make decisions based on facts they're given, but I knew that we weren't given a lot of facts. And my research put me in touch with actually Bulger, his girlfriend Catherine Gregg, John Connolly, the FBI agent. I've been to see Bulger 3 times and interview him.
Really?
Yeah.
What was that like?
Scary the first time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really was frightened. He's a complex individual, you know. He's definitely got that criminal aspect to him, but there's also, he's human,
mm-hmm,
you know. That's,
so what are the facts that weren't revealed in the trial, and are they revealed in the book?
That Bulger claims, and I do believe from the trial itself, even before talking to Bulger, that he was never an informant, that everything we know about Bulger was based on the testimony of 5 individuals who obtained outrageous deals from the Department of Justice in Boston, the Boston U.S. Attorney's Office, for what they had to say about Bulger. And all of these individuals never thought Bulger would be captured, first of all.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then the jury itself, half of us in deliberations, would not take the testimony of these individuals seriously because we felt the deals they received were so outrageous, anyone would have lied to get what they got.
So what was the motivating factor behind that, Janet? I mean, you know, why were those secrets kept?
Well, you know, that's a good question,
yeah.
And it's even deeper than I know right now, but
okay.
It needs to be looked into. And how can you take in just those five witnesses,
mm-hmm.
take four of them appeared in court, one of them did not, but wrote a book about it.
Mm.
But the amount of murders they admitted to committing are close to 100 probably. And if you put that in the scales of justice,
mm-hmm.
how do those 100 murders weigh less than Bulger's murders? How does their combined criminality
mm-hmm.
weigh less than Bulger's?
Mm-hmm.
So there's a reason they wanted him silenced. And what a lot of people don't know is the trial never had to be because Bulger wanted to plead guilty and accept even the death penalty with no appeal.
Really?
Yes. So it was, in my opinion,
yeah.
a very orchestrated trial and a very protected story.
Hmm. Now, you also kind of take the media to task in the book, do you not,
for
not delving further into this? Yeah.
Not delving further, and also I've found since the book's come out, actually,
yeah.
Boston media doesn't want to touch it because we have a number of journalists, both from the Globe and the Herald, who have written books themselves based on the testimony of these five individuals I just told you about.
Right.
All of the stories are based on that. None of them have talked to Bulger. None of them have corresponded with Bulger.
Yep.
How can you say you're a journalist putting out facts when you haven't even attempted to be in touch with that individual?
Wow, this experience profoundly touched you, didn't it?
It really did. Changed my life.
Yeah.
It really did.
Mm-hmm. Did it set you on a new course?
It has.
Really?
It has set me on. And since the book has come out, strangely enough, it's circulating within different prisons. And I'm getting letters from prisoners.
Yep.
Basically just saying thank you for writing it. And I hope that I have a juror like you in my trial.
Well.
One of these individuals has been in prison for 8 years without a trial. I mean, these are the things that are going on.
Mm.
So I'm kind of exploring maybe writing some of their stories
mm-hmm.
next.
Have you heard from Bulger himself?
Bulger has not been given the book
oh,
yet.
Okay.
They just haven't given the book yet. I hear from Bulger. I just got a letter from him yesterday, so I hear from him frequently, but he still has not received the book.
Oh, all right.
Catherine,
does he know about
Craig
it?
Another person I had sent one to, yeah.
Yeah.
Just mm-hmm.
But does he know about the book?
Oh, yes.
Oh, he does.
Yeah,
okay.
He does. Mm-hmm.
I'm sure he wants to read it.
I think he probably does.
Yeah. How long is the book, Janet?
The book is almost 400 pages.
Oh, okay.
I believe, yeah. And in the end, I tell the story, as I said, as a Romana Clay.
Which is kind of fiction, right?
It's fiction, but truthful.
Yep.
You know, you're kind of protecting characters and
I
whatnot.
See.
And in the end, I have almost 30 pages of actual excerpts from letters from Bulger regarding different individuals.
Okay. So how does the story proceed? You know, where does it start? Where does it go through? Where does it end?
It starts with the jury pool.
Okay.
Yes, and it ends after the trial
okay.
as I'm investigating things, yeah.
Okay. So this is your experience then?
My experience,
yeah.
yes.
Are there any photographs in the book?
In the book, no.
No.
No, not of the trial or
okay.
anything like that, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you mentioned that you're being asked by other folks to write. Is there another project in the works right now?
Starting to
okay.
interview people in regard to that. And another area that probably I'd go forward with is a lot of people don't realize Bulger's involvement in the MK Ultra project, the CIA experimentation back in the 50s and 60s. They were experimenting with LSD, basically,
mm-hmm.
On people that had no idea what was being done to them. And according to the United States Senate hearing in 1977, they were attempting to modify behavior, maybe born identity series kind
mm-hmm,
of based
mm-hmm,
on that,
mm-hmm.
but also modify it to the point of making an individual homicidal. When Bulger was put through this, he was 26 years old. He had never killed anybody. Another person that was part of that experimentation was Ted Kaczynski, the Unabomber.
Mm-hmm.
He was a student at Harvard at the time.
Wow.
So that's another area it's kind of taking me into.
Okay. It sounds like you have a brand new future.
Yeah, I'd rather go back to the American Revolution.
Yeah. Well, I think think you're being called in a different direction right now. Yeah. What will be happening here at the library? Again, Tuesday, September 11th, 7 to 8 p.m. What's the presentation include?
I'll be giving a PowerPoint presentation, okay, in the actual trial, mm-hmm, and my what I've come to understand and my opinions about what I've come to,
okay,
understand.
Yeah.
Yes, and I go into kind of wrap it up with what I was just, the MK Ultra.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When did the book come out, Janet?
The book came out in April.
Oh, so recently.
Yes,
okay,
recent.
Mm-hmm. Have you done any other public presentations?
I have, yeah, yes.
Mm-hmm. And how do those go?
They've gone well.
Yeah,
yeah, they're received well. People are usually shocked in hearing, you know, the behind-the-scenes stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I would think.
Yeah.
Well, we look forward to your presentation here. Thank you so much for coming over
to
share.
Thank you very much.
And good luck with this project and with future projects,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. And again, that is Janet Uhlar coming to the Thomas Crane Public Library, presenting on her new book, The Truth Be Damned, part of the library's Crime by the Book series, Tuesday, September 11th, 7 to 8 p.m. To learn more about this or other programs at the library, visit their website, thomascranelibrary.org.